Alright people, now the Legend of Spyro series is done, let's move on to another recent game that is really cool. Kirby's Return to Dream Land. Only on Wii. I heard this game was supposed to come out for GameCube, but it got held off a long time apparently. Now they're releasing it for Wii, which I say works better for.
King Dedede!
Bottle D!
Meta Knight! Kirby's Return to Dreamland! Ha! Dedede. We are going to do extra mode. Or not. I already did the opening cutscene for this, so. I'm gonna start a file that shows the opening cutscene, then we're gonna just do extra mode. Oh, it's falling apart. Oh, look at those little gears. Those look really important. Oh, they're in bubbles. That's basically the plot. We're gonna fix his ship. Not in this file. We're gonna do... theater. I gotta just watch the damn cutscene from the theater, couldn't I? Yeah, certainly could have. So then, let's do extra mode. World 1, Cookie Country. Well, see, level 1, but it's more or less a world. Now, like any Kirby game, each world has a certain number of X. And in these X, we have collectibles. 4 players at any time, blah 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 blah. I'm doing single player, but you can have up to 4 players. 1 Kirby, 1 Wild D, DDD, and Meta Knight. But yeah, believe it or not, DDD is on our side here. So I never did extra mode before, I want to know what's different about it. And yeah, like usually can inhale enemies and copy their drone. Oh, I see what's there. We got less health. Oh, that'll make it challenging. These little stars have holes in them for some reason. Yeah, 100 stars will get you a 1-up, like usual, and you can float. Oh yeah, in most Kirby games, your copy abilities would sort of like have one attack, that's what I've experienced, but some of the things you can do with each copy ability, like up attack, running attack, you can even charge your attack. Yeah. This game is actually extremely similar to the Smash Brothers series, which would make sense seeing as Kirby and Smash Brothers are made by the same people. But this one is very similar to Smash Brothers. I mean, we even got this whole key thing, like from Smash Bros. Brawl. Energy spheres are scattered across the land. Try to find all the hidden ones. So yeah, that's the collectible of the game, the energy spheres. Kirby also has a super inhale. He's in the sucking steel blocks. What up? All the ones are designed differently too. It's they're just Kirby crowns instead of just, you know, regular one-ups. This is a really great game, especially the music here. Haha. The graphics are pretty sweet too. They look like GameCube graphics, so yeah. Check this out! Super abilities! Ultra Sword! Use super abilities to unlock incredible power! Destroy everything! Careful, it's timed! Super abilities, you can unlock Nightmare Zone. And the portals are red in this file. Aha! The objective? Outrun the nightmare barrier. You can shoot stuff at it, knock it back. It was purple in the other file, but in extra mode, it's red. Choose your power, Sword. Here, you can fight Sphere Doomer X. Huh, they got one eye, and they're much powerful. So be careful. But it's level one, so he's not so hard. Kill Sphere Doomer to get two spheres. Fair deal, I must say. And when you clear level, jump as high as you can! And I can never get a 1 for some reason. I don't really know how it works. Turnabout does, though. Sadly, this game doesn't grade you. Kirby's Epic Yarn is the only one that grades you. However, there are certain bonus levels here that do grade you. Next time, we'll begin Act 2.